All the notifications that we send are sent to your notifications are received in your notification center. So clicking on the notification center will take you to the notification center where you can see all the notifications which have been sent for the IFL under different tags, news, IFL ideas, etc. So there's a filter which you can use for, let's say you are interested only in knowing the IFL ideas for the day. You can use this filter, and this filter will help you the filtered view of all the IFL ideas for the day. You can select news also, so these are all the news, RIL, consolidated profit, etc. And this way you can track off different segments from here. You can see your the price alert notification that you have received for the day, and also you can see your trade and order notifications. You know, since you don't have any order for the day, it's saying no order found. So in this you can keep track of all the notifications that you receive, even if you swipe out from your notification tray. This will help you to keep yourself updated on that. Now let's check out the settings option given in the menu. So the settings option is very helpful, which helps us to understand how you want to use your app. So at the top you can see there's a news notification, whether you want to receive the news or not, you can select from here. So this is high low, you can use for knowing whether you want to, when you want to receive your order and trade confirmations. On selection of high, you will get the notification for your order and trade immediately as they are confirmed, and low will send you the notification at the end of the day as a combined thing. You can also get notifications for order confirmation, trade confirm. You can choose from here. You can select your timeout session, whether you want 15 minutes timeout or 4 hours timeout for your app. What is the refresh that you want? So it selecting low will help you to consume low data, but at the same time you will get low refresh rate, which is not very advisable. So you can select your chart type from here, whether you want to see the default chart type as candle, colored bar or line. You can also select your default opening page, whether you want is a market dashboard or default watch list or the idea section. You can change your password, and you can also set as price alert notification different sound if you want for that. Let's say so there's some default sound for notification, and if you want to change it, you can select yes from here and you get different notification for that.